The recent amendments to Right to Information Act 2005 was a major discussion in the month of July and October 2019. Government of India or Parliament of India has passed certain amendments to Right to Information Act 2005. As all of you know, Right to Information Act 2005 was one of the most important historic legislation passed by the Parliament of India. Hello everyone, welcome to Academy of Civil Services. I am Dr. Sajith. Today we are discussing about the amendments to the Right to Information Act 2005 in our daily current affairs session. To get the daily current affairs from Academy of Civil Services, I request all of you to subscribe our channel. Don't forget to press the bell icon as well, then you will get a notification whenever we upload a useful current affairs video for the UPSC or any other civil services preparation. As all of you know, Right to Information Act was one of the most historic acts passed by the Parliament of India in 2005, and simply we call that as the RTI Act 2005. According to RTI Act 2005, we can get information from any government office except few offices which are excluded or which are exempted from giving amendments. For example, an office of government which is related to the national security, like Intelligence Bureau and like BSF, and from these institutions we may not get the information. From all other regular normal informations of government, we can get information. If you submit an application to get an information from any government office, in normal situations you will get the information within 30 days of submitting application. Now imagine you applied for a particular information from any government institution. For example, take a government university. You wanted to get a particular information. You applied for that. Every government office will have a certain office named as Public Information Officer, or simply PIO. You submitted an application. Within 30 days, you have to get the information which you requested for. Imagine you did not get the information within 30 days. Then there are two appellate authorities. You can give an appeal into two higher authorities. If the government office is a state government office, you can approach the State Information Commission. State Information Commission, according to Right to Information Act 2005, is composed of one Chief Information Commissioner, and not more than 10 commissioners will be there in the State Information Commission. If the government office is a central government office, then you can approach to an higher authority named as Central Information Commission. Central Information Commission is also composed of one Chief Information Commissioner and the 10 information commissioners. Now, our discussion today is that by making an amendment to Right to Information Act 2005 in 2019, certain changes have been brought in the powers of State Information Commission and the Central Information Commission. We can see what are the changes brought by the amendment in 2019. 2019 amendment has brought certain changes to the powers of the State Central Information Commissioner and the Central Information Commissioners and the State Information Commission. For example, in 2005 Act, there was a 2005 Right to Information Act had given a secure term for the Chief Information Commissioners in the center and the state and other information commissioners. Then information, simply when I am making a comment, information commissioners in India, that includes Chief Information Commissioner at the center and Chief Information Commissioner at the state and other information commissioners both at the center and the states. Then information commissioners were given a guaranteed term. Once appointed, they can continue in the office for a term of 5 years or 65 years of age, whichever comes earlier. Then whether 65 years of age becomes earlier, they have to retire at the age of 65. Otherwise, they can continue at the age up till 5 years. For example, imagine If a person is appointed as Chief Information Commissioner of India at the age of 62, he can continue only for 3 years, because by 3 years he will be 65 years of age. And if another person is appointed as the Chief Information Commissioner or Information Commissioners at the age of 50, obviously he can continue for 5 years. Then either 5 years or 65 years, whichever comes earlier, that is the term of the Information Commissioners according to 2005 Act. Now, by bringing an amendment to this in 2019, according to 2019 amendment, the term has been removed. How much will be that this 5 year or 65 years guaranteed term has been removed, and it mentions that the term will be decided by Government of India. Government decides from time to time. Future government, now the present government, will decide what will be the term of this Chief Information Commissioner and the Information Commissioners. After 5 years, when another government comes, that government can decide what will be the term. That somewhere it has been criticized as a disempowering the Chief Information Commissioner and the Information Commissioners in India. Accordingly, because government decides, then government has to decide the term of Chief Information Commissioner and Information Commissioners throughout India. Government has brought the RTI rules 2019. RTI rules were brought on 24th October 2019. In the month of October, government has released the new RTI rules 2019. According to RTI rules, the term for the Chief Information Commissioner and Information Commissioners has been reduced from the 5 years which were guaranteed earlier into 3 years. Then now the term is 3 years and or 65 years of age. Retirement age has been kept as same. Then if a person is appointed when he is 64, he will get only 1 year. If a person is appointed when he is 60, he will get maximum 3 years term. Then this is one of the most important amendments brought by the Right to Information Act amendment in 2019. We can see the second most important amendment was that. The second amendment is related to the salary and allowances of Chief Information Commissioner and Information Commissioners in India. In the original act passed in 2005, it was mentioned that Chief Information Commissioner will get a salary equal to the Chief Election Commissioner of India. Whatever salary is given to Chief Election Commissioner, that would be given to Chief Information Commissioner. Now, that is at the center. Then in the center, Central Information Commission, whatever salary is given to Chief Election Commissioner of India, all of you will be knowing that we have a 3-member election commission at present. One Chief Election Commissioner is there and 2 election commissioners are there. Then Central Information Commission, Chief Information Commissioner will get a salary that is equal to Chief Election Commissioner of India, and the other information commissioners, and maximum not more than 10 information commissioners can be there in the center. Then these 10 information commissioners, they will get a salary equal to election commissioner in India. Next one, in the State Information Commission. The State Information Commission, Chief Information Commissioner in the state, then he will get a salary equal to the State Election Commissioner. Whatever salary is given to State Election Commissioner, that should be given to the Chief Information Commissioner of a state. Now, the other commissioners, states can also have maximum up to 10 information commissioners can be there. Then other information commissioners in the state will get the salary of the Chief Secretary of the state. Chief Secretary of the state is the head of bureaucracy in a state. The highest bureaucratic position in a state is held by the Chief Secretary of the state. Whatever salary he gets, that should be given to the Chief Information Commissioners of a state. That was the earlier law passed in 2005. Now we can see the amendment in 2019, and 2019 has brought a new rule that government decides whatever is the salary. Now the present government can decide whatever salary they will give to Chief Information Commissioner and Information Commissioners. After 5 years, if a new government comes, then they can also decide that what will be the salary accordingly. In October 2019, government has released a new RTI rules 2019. According to RTI rules 2019, government has declared that the Chief Information Commissioner will get a salary of 2.5 lakh rupees and other information commissioners in the nation, they will get a salary of 2.25 lakh rupees salary. And this is the new salary as given by the 2019 government rules. Then this is the current affairs we are discussing today, that is the amendment in 2019 to the Right to Information Act 2005. Right to Information Act, and we have discussed in detail in our Indian Polity material. If you want to know more about Right to Information Act 2005 and other provisions related to that, you can refer the Indian Polity material of Academy of Civil Services. I'm stopping here for today, and stay tuned for every day. We will upload at least one current affairs every day in our YouTube channel, and that will definitely help you for the preparation of civil services examinations, especially the Union Public Service Commission civil service examination. We are focusing through this channel, and I once again request you, subscribe our channel, press the bell icon, you will get a notification. Definitely these classes will help you in your upcoming civil services examination. Thank you for watching, and best of luck from the team Academy of Civil Services.